Good morning. It's Sunday. We are on our way to, we're getting ready to leave to church, for church. I am totally dressed, I'm totally ready, and I'm in the car before anybody else. That's because I'm not staying forever today. Why, I have no idea. But, we're getting ready to leave. So, yay! A bacon cheeseburger, no onion. Do you want that number 8?
Yeah, No.
The sandwich that you would order, we don't offer.
Oh, you don't have that anymore, huh? Okay.
I'd like a number 9 then.
I'll take a number 9 then.
Yeah. Would you like a small, medium, or large size?
Mead.
Medium.
And what was the drink?
Strawberry lemonade. You still have the Gouda
bacon cheese?
Yeah.
I want that with the no onions and the medium with strawberry lemonade.
We'll take one of those with no onion.
Would you like that in a combo meal?
Yes, please. Medium. And also strawberry lemonade. And I'll take the number 5.
Medium as well?
Medium, yeah.
What's your drink?
Sprite.
Anything else?
That's it, thanks.
Would you like to donate a dollar sign for a few pics of our Valentine's coupon?
Sure.
Okay, 24 is your total. Thank you.
Thank you.
I bet you'll be able to reach us. Because that's all you have.
Look at it snow. See, hi everybody. We're gonna take a nap. On my skirt. It's red. Blackish. weird. What is it?
Beep in a minute.
Okay, we'll figure that out in a little bit.
I came into the house after a day of hard work in the fields. Her daughter, Miriam, poured her a glass of sweetened water. Jochebed's young son, Aaron, laid at her feet. Miriam could tell that something was troubling her mother. "I have dreadful news," said Jochebed. "It is not enough that Pharaoh has turned us into slaves and made our days miserable. Though we were treated harshly, we continue to grow in size and strength. So Pharaoh is afraid of us, afraid that we will rise up against him, or that we will help an enemy that tries to conquer him. But how could Pharaoh treat us any more harshly?" Miriam asked her mother. "There is worse to come, my child," said her mother. "Pharaoh has ordered the Israelite nurses to kill all baby boys born to us." "That's dreadful, mother," Miriam exclaimed. "What if our new baby is a boy?" "God will help us," Jochebed said. As the weeks passed, Jochebed brought news to the field that all new Israelite baby boys were well after all. The nurses refused to do as Pharaoh ordered. "Perhaps we do not need to worry so." Later, Miriam went to the well, where the women drew water for their households and exchanged news. A kind woman helped Miriam pull up the heavy pail from the well. The woman leaned close to Miriam and quietly told her something. When Miriam got home, she sadly told her mother what the woman at the well had said. "Pharaoh was angry that his orders weren't obeyed," Miriam told her. "Now he has ordered all the Egyptians to throw every Israelite baby boy into the Nile River." A few days later, Jochebed called Miriam to her side. "Miriam," said Jochebed, "it is time to get the nurse to help me with the new baby. But be careful not to let anyone else know." Soon Miriam was back with the nurse. Miriam left the nurse with her mother and took Aaron down to the river. "I'll show you how to make a little raft of woven reeds to float in the Nile," said Miriam to Aaron. Miriam took care of Aaron at the river all afternoon. When Miriam brought Aaron back home at dinner time, there was a new baby in the house. "Meet your new baby brother," said Jochebed happily. "He is such a beautiful baby," said Miriam as she kissed his forehead. "We must hide him from sight," said Jochebed. "I'll help you," said Miriam. For 3 long months, the family took care of the little baby without the Egyptians knowing about him. When the Egyptians made their sweeping searches of Israelite homes and yards, Jochebed hid her little baby in a basket. One day, Miriam went to the river's edge to gather reeds made of baskets, or to make baskets. Suddenly, Pharaoh's daughter came to the river with her servants. "I have seen the princess here before," thought Miriam. "I must remember for what days she comes to the river to bathe." One morning, Jochebed said, "I don't think we can hide the baby much longer." "Do not worry," Miriam said. "I have a plan." Miriam helped her mother make a special basket in the shape of a little boat. Before full light, Miriam and her mother quietly took the baby in the basket to the place of the riverbed where Pharaoh's daughter bathed. There, the Israelite mother and the daughter set the basket in the reeds. The basket bobbed gently in the river, lulling the baby to sleep. Jochebed went back home to wait and to pray. Miriam stayed hidden in the tall reeds and grass. After some time passed, Miriam began to worry that the princess would not come to the river. Suddenly, Miriam heard the chatter of the princess and her servants. Just as the princess was about to step in the water, she saw the little beautiful basket caught in the reeds. "Bring me that little boat-shaped basket," she said to her handmaid. The handmaid waded into the reeds and returned with the basket. As she set it on the ground, as the princess's feet, soft sounds were heard from the side. "How can we take care of this little child?" the princess asked her handmaid. "The poor little child must be very hungry." Miriam thought the princess must have a good and kind heart, so she quietly made her way out to the reef. Then she gravely asked the princess, "Shall I go and find an Israelite to nurse and take care of this baby for you?" The princess smiled at Miriam. "Child, If you can bring such a woman to me, I will pay her to care for this baby until you leave. Miriam ran home to tell her mother the good news. Then Miriam and her mother returned to the riverbank as fast as they could. Jochebed saw the princess with her baby. She could tell that the princess did indeed have a kind heart. I will pay you to take care of this baby until he agrees, said the princess. And then I will raise him as my own. He will be a prince of Egypt. Jochebed was so happy. His name shall be Moses, the princess said. It means that he was drawn out of the water. Then the princess gave Jochebed a ring to show any Egyptian who tried to take the baby. Jochebed and Miriam were filled with hope and happiness. Miriam hugged Moses tightly and thanked God for protecting the baby.